Hey friends, in this video I'm going to be talking to you about the best method for studying anything. That's a big claim, so I'm going to back that up with some evidence and proof as well. The video is going to have three sections. First of all, we're going to take a look at the ways that you're probably revising now. These are the most common ways that students like to revise, and I'm going to break down why these probably are not the best ways. Next, I'm going to introduce you to the holy grail of revision techniques and talk to you about why that works. Lastly, we're going to talk about how you can integrate this method into practical steps that you can take. So we're going to talk about how you can use these methods to get better results in your revision. I really hope that everyone watching is going to watch the whole way through, and you're going to take some of these points and you're going to include them in your studying so you get better results. I would really appreciate a little like and maybe even a comment. If you find this video useful, remember you can subscribe and then you get notified whenever I upload one of these new videos. This is going to be a bit of a new section on the channel. As a medical student, I have to revise a lot. And so I spent a lot of time kind of working out what works for me and doing a bit of research about what works for everyone. So you can expect a few more of these videos just like this coming up soon. Sorry to tell you, but the way you're studying is just not cutting it. Everyone has their own way of studying. We're all individuals, we all learn in our own ways. And if you're watching this video, maybe you've just started a new course, maybe you're a student and you're feeling like, there's no exam that's coming up, it really matters and I need to do well. And so, am I revising well enough? I just don't know. Maybe you're just bored of whatever you're currently doing. I would say almost every single student that I've ever spoken to, at least, and probably in the world, although that's a very big claim, is going to be doing one of these two methods of revision. Either creating and writing notes, or reading textbooks and highlighting them. Now, I can very safely say that there have been big periods of my life when these two methods were the only thing I did when I was revising. Probably right the way up to the end of my first year of university, to be honest. Those, I would say, were the two things that I did the majority of the time when I was revising. I might be in the library or in my room or in a coffee shop, and I would be watching a lecture online and writing down some notes, only to then never look at those notes again. Creating and reading notes. Now, in university or college, if you're in the States, this is definitely the most commonly used revision technique. This is the way that almost everyone is going to be studying. Students will attend a lecture, or you know, these days they will be watching a lecture online, and they'll create some fairly detailed notes about everything that the lecturer has said that might be important. Now, if you're a really good student, you may even finish that lecture and the same night, a couple of weeks later, have a look over those long, extensive lecture notes that you took and rewrite some of them, maybe to kind of highlight some of the most important things, to focus in on some of those key facts that you need to remember. However, there are several issues with this revision technique of just kind of creating and writing notes. First of all, those notes you're taking, they're almost definitely too detailed and too extensive, and there is no way you can remember them unless you're someone with a photographic memory. And if you are, I'm sorry, I hate you, because that's just not fair. At the same time, those notes you've made, they've relied on you listening and paying attention while writing. And so even though they're too detailed and too extensive, you've probably also missed some key information in there. This is not to say that you shouldn't be making notes. Please don't leave this video, storm off and go and burn all your notes to the ground. But this should not be your revision technique. Revision and studying, that is taking that information and implanting it somewhere in your brain so that you can access it. Notes are great, but notes are only the start of a far more effective way of learning. The second way, and probably the most common thing you'll see anyone doing if you go into a university library, is reading and highlighting either lecture notes, textbooks, or your own notes. To be fair, this is better than just having written the notes and then never looking at them again. And highlighting, you're incorporating something physical that you're doing, you're incorporating some colour, and those are definitely good. It's probably not working as well as you think it is though. Don't get me wrong. Highlighting your notes and creating those notes in the first place, they're not awful. They definitely have their place in this perfect studying workflow, but they're not working as well as you think, and you need to be honest with yourself. Okay, studying, this is something you're doing for yourself, and so you need to be honest with yourself about how well it's working. Highlighting information does nothing to pick the information up and put it in your brain. Yes, it looks pretty afterwards, and yes, if you then went back a third time to look at that page, you might be more easily able to see which bits of information you cared about when you went through and highlighted. Personally, in a medical textbook, if I try and highlight important information, I end up with a full page of highlights. But no matter how pretty the page looks, that information is well and truly still stuck onto the page and not stuck in my brain. I've told you that whatever it is you're doing probably isn't working so well, and hopefully I haven't crushed your dreams too much. But what do I propose you do instead? On to section two. Repetition is king. Okay, say it again. Repetition is king. The secret to remembering anything is really simple. Repetition. So by getting information, repeatedly putting it into your brain, and then repeatedly extracting that information from your neurons by testing yourself, for example, that is the best way to cement knowledge inside your head, to make it stick for pretty much forever, as long as you keep doing a few reps every now and then. And this is the secret to studying anything. Let's have a little bit of an analogy. Training your brain, it's just like training your body. No one expects to go into a gym, do one squat, a deadlift, two pull-ups, go home, have a single healthy meal, sit back and go, yep, that's me, done, I'm now hench. Learning is not any different. Do you want big muscles or six-pack abs? You've got to get your reps in. Learning, just the same, don't treat it any differently. You want to keep that information in your head? You got to get your reps in. If I want to remember something forever, indefinitely, or more likely, in most people's case, if I want to learn information long enough and be able to access it in an exam, I need to get my repetitions in. So multiple studies have found that repetition is one of the best ways of retaining information. I'm going to link a few of those down below because I think it's important that you don't just take my word for that. You need to go and have a look at the information yourself. So it's not procrastination. This counts as learning. Go down, have a look at those links, have a look at some of those studies. This retrieval-based learning method, so where you're putting information in your head and then you're teaching yourself and you're testing yourself by retrieving that information again, this has been shown to be the most effective way of learning anything. Retrieval practice has also been shown to improve a student's ability to make inferences between information. Learning something better means that you can use that information better. Anyone who's particularly perceptive may notice there's a little bit of a change of scenery here. I was living down in Ashford at William Harvey Hospital in Kent for my paediatric placement, but that's finished now and it's almost Christmas, so I've moved back into my family home. Apologies that that's taken place in the middle of filming a video, but what can we do? It's 2020. Life is just full of upsets. Now that we know the theory behind better studying and more effective studying, it's time to put that into practice. And I mean practice because that's what learning really is. Technique number one is flashcards and active recall. If you know me, then you know that I'm a recent but a very staunch convert to flashcards. I only started using flashcards in my second year of uni, but instantly I saw big results. Personally, I think it's much more important how you're using these flashcards more than whether you've written them yourself or downloaded a deck from someone else. I tend to make my own, but that's because I can then tailor them more to my learning style. I can decide how much pictures or how little pictures I want to put in there. And also I get complete control over what platform I'm doing them on. What we're using these flashcards for is active recall. We want to have a flashcard that gives us a prompt on the front of the card, if it's a physical card, or, you know, in the header, if it's a virtual card. And then we want to be dredging up as much anatomy, physiology, information about the condition as we can for that particular prompt. This recall of information, this needs to be done unguided. So all you've got is the information on that prompt. This is one of flashcards' biggest strength, is that you're testing yourself, but you're testing yourself by yourself. This only needs you and your set of flashcards, and you've got an amazing revision technique. I've really changed where I've made my flashcards over the years. Initially, I made them in the first app I found on the App Store that was called Chegg, which was a big mistake, to be honest, because I can't export directly any of my flashcards that I've made in there, all of the several thousand. I then had to go at making physical ones, but I found that they just ended up in the bottom of my bag. My laptop went on top of them. They all got torn up and crooked. I'm now using Notion to make my flashcards. The most popular way that anyone makes flashcards in medical school is, of course, Anki. You can't really be a medical student without having heard Anki thrown about all over the place. I've only very recently started using Anki, and for me, I can see its strengths, I just don't know if it's the right kind of platform or software for me. Anki's biggest strength is what we're moving on to next, and that's spaced repetition. Technique number two, spaced repetition. Spaced repetition is the practice of leaving planned and increasing gaps in between testing yourself on a particular piece of information. By increasing this time, and by remembering to revisit everything at some point, you're able to actually remember anything indefinitely. Anki flashcards make this incredibly easy. They do this very well. Depending on whether you've got a question right or wrong, it will give you the question again in a certain amount of time. But I've also found a way to do this on me and I think everyone's favorite productivity app, Notion. If you're interested in learning about how I use spaced repetition using coding inside of Notion, then please leave a comment below and I'll make another video all about that. Absolutely anything can be learned using spaced repetition. It doesn't have to be medicine. It doesn't have to be from flashcards even. If you're learning a new language, for example, make sure you revisit the basics as often as possible. Make sure you keep using the language rather than having a long period of time where you're not using it, and you'll find that your memory for that language really dramatically increases. Technique number three. We've been talking about repetition, we've been talking about reps, and that wouldn't be complete without talking about questions. Questions are a fantastic way of making you find those connections inside of your head, fire up those neurons, and pull the information out. You will not talk to a single senior medical student who's done well in their exams who hasn't used questions and question banks as a huge part of their revision. In order to answer a question, we need to actively and repeatedly access information inside of our brains. The important part I'm going to add here, which I think some people don't do, and I've definitely fallen foul of myself, is you need to repeat everything, okay? You don't do these questions once, and you don't only repeat the questions you've got wrong, you repeat all of them regularly. I've definitely fallen into this trap. You know, you think you know something, and so you don't revise it, and then you come up to the exam and you end up doing worst in the part that you thought you were strongest at, because that's the part you haven't revisited. My physics AS levels and physics A level was just like this. I thought I was going to get a fantastic grade, and so I didn't revise physics much when it came to my final A level exams, which was very stupid, and it meant that I got a D in my last exams for it, and so I got a B overall. Don't make the same mistakes as me. Let me make them for you. Revise everything, even the things you think are easy. I hope you found this brief but hopefully interesting guide to studying effectively useful. I'm planning on this being quite a regular section on this channel, so I'm going to expand the content of the videos as my own learning expands, and we'll try and talk about the other techniques that I use in my revision. As I said, I've been using flashcards with spaced repetition and active recall in Notion using a little bit of code, and if you're interested in that, then please leave a comment below and we can talk all about how to do that yourself. The next video in this series is going to be about making notes in medical school and how I go from lecture slides to notes and then to flashcards. Make sure you press the little bell next to the subscribe button that you've already pressed, and you'll get notified when that video gets uploaded. That way you can be among the first to watch and the first to get ahead in medical school.